heir to me. Put dust on you, Vegeta, run up and I'm airing the scene. I feel just like Vegeta Prince and I'm an heir to the seat. I mean, for real. Touch the driver's soft so I don't even grab the wheel. That's all on my chest, but it don't mean a man is stealing. Man, I'm walking with some money, man, I mean a couple mil. Ew, think you need a meal. You ain't even eating while I'm feasting in the field. That's why I'm always cheesing, cause I feel like Uncle Phil. And all this losers think they're fresh, but they ain't half the man as well.
Today, from Lucas Oil Stadium in Indianapolis, it's week 15 of the NFL on EA Sports. Colts. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. And got his man complete. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. 39 yards there, a big one.
Press coverage on the outside, and for defenders, that's the ultimate risk reward. If you take the risk, can you reward yourself by keeping them on the line of scrimmage? But no, not on that one. Got the step on him. Now it's just a matter of laying the ball out there for him to go get.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. He'll look to throw. Buying time to his left. He'll run it and brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
Being chased out left. Left side, Doyle with it. He'll head out of bounds inside the 10. Mark it down at the 9. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. They'll drop the throw. His pass caught at the 4. Get into the end zone. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Josh Hill, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Colts are an extra point away from tying up this football game.
The tight end position has always been dangerous, especially in the red zone, short field. But now even more so because these tight ends.
Fake. They'll look to throw. And going deep for Hill. It's caught inside the 25. A huge play that time for the Colts. 53 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone. Looking to throw. Dancing to his left. He's going to take off with it. And able to get this down inside the 15, either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
Flushed out right. Takes this one in for a Colts touchdown. Tyreek Hill standing alone with a new NFL record 32nd touchdown. And the Colts are able to grow their lead.
If you did didn't know it, it won't surprise you to find out that this team leads the league in scoring. They've been a quick strike team all season long. There's another example. They did it again. This offensive coordinator.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And they're going deep for Hill. That's caught inside the 20. A good play there for Indy. 53 yards. Excellent execution, and now they're set up nicely.
Are they ever? Red zone? I wonder what the next play call is going to be, because after a big play like that, a lot of teams like to use the momentum to launch another one.
Side of the field now. It's first and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Forced out to his left. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them, and I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down. Now back to throw. Steps away to his left. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
So much for the best laid plans and best designed plays. That was good coverage along the sidelines. No place for that one to get in there. It sails incomplete.
Back to the end zone. Could he get his down? No, it's incomplete. Of a ball mere inches from the white line on third and goal.
Third and goal.
They'll look to throw. Buying time to his left. He may try and run for this. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. Decent gain on the scramble to six, but now it's fourth.
Fourth down.
And he's got his target. It's caught for a Colts touchdown. Josh Hill. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Colts, they add on to their advantage. Big fourth down conversion for the score and the defense. That is a tough pill to swallow.
Big time for them. How about them just deciding to go for it on fourth down? And
on play action, they'll throw. And they're going deep for Hill. This is caught inside the 15. And he's a long ways into Washington territory before hitting the turf.
First, when I see a route like that, I don't know how anybody stays with these receivers. Because he curled back. I thought he was going to stop. Then he just took off.
He really gave the impression that the curl was the end of the route. But when he turned it upfield and the throw,
till they hit Painter, but don't count it in. There's laundry on the field. We'll see what the penalty flag is about.
When they score and you see the excitement, and then when they realize those points aren't going to count, can they get it back together and find their way back to the end zone?
And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. Clearly wasn't outside of the tackle box. There's your penalty.
And accompanying that penalty, a loss of down.
They'll set up to throw. Being chased out left. Now he'll pull it down. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. Pretty nice gain on the scramble. Gets him 12 yards.
Partner was a definite passing down, but he was able to leak out and pick up some good yardage, even though the coverage was excellent. Maybe it's not exactly how they drew it up, but he still got a big chunk of yardage on second down.
And he will go down outside of the pocket for a sack, trying to get away.
Washington now going to use the... throw now on the final play. And going deep for Hill. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. So we reach halftime. And now due to apparent... Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And going deep for Hill. And it's caught inside the 30. And they do finally get him, but he takes it to the 25. What a game it's been for this duo.
They remind me of a good comedy team. They know how to play off of each other so well. No matter how one riffs, the other's right there to pick them up, and they are shredding them in this ballgame.
Yeah, boy, and it's tough to bring him down that time. He surges forward. He's going to get a full six out of that. Second down.
It's a pickup of six. Brings up second and four.
They'll go again here with Matt. And he's going to be stopped close to the first down marker at Washington's 12-yard line. It's 14. They show run with three tight ends here on first down.
14-yard line.
Now Mack. And they get to him quickly here as he's stopped right around the 13.
Ball carrier.
The tackle by Matthew Ioannidis. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
And they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
And he's going to get forward for about five, but that may be coming back. What say you, Mr. Referee? Face a second and long following the holding penalty. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And it is caught. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Tyreek Hill there to make the grab. And the Colts add on to their lead. And man, Charles, talk about zinging something in there. Those gloves, they help with one-handed catches, the fun stuff. Any padding for a rocket like that?
One would think so, but I'll guarantee you this, after that throw, his hands will hurt later, not right now.
They go play action here on first down. And they drop him for a loss, but penalty markers are on the field. Let's see about the call.
Face mask. Defense.
Officials so cognizant of that call nowadays, but that one looked pretty easy.
Yeah, you're right. They took out of their hands having to wonder whether it's a 5-yard or a 15-yard inadvertent or not. Now, it's a lot easier. You see it, you call it.
And going deep for Hill. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Pass interference. Defense.
Man, that ain't me. This home crowd, they're happy with that call.
I like the way you said happy there, right? The so-called good guys didn't get a call. They feel like it's been that way all afternoon. You feeling their pain?
They finally got one.
Yes, they did.
And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought down.
He was brought down.
It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
On the pickup. Second and six.
Staying on the ground with Mack. And he's going to be stopped close to the first down marker at Washington's 12-yard line. 19-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down.
First and 10 at the 19-yard line.
They'll run here with Mack. And good downhill running. He's got 6 yards down to the 13.
Ball carrier.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And the Colts are going to have a first and goal as he's inside the 10, down to the 7-yard line. And they've got three tight ends here on first and goal to add some extra mass. They'll run here with Mack. And the Colts are going to have it first and goal as he'll take this down to about the 3. When we talk about being on schedule, I think they're on schedule after that run, getting it right down there on the doorstep.
Maybe even a little bit ahead because now the defense can't dictate with pressure. They're guessing about where you're going to go. I might come right back at them with the same play, the same set, and see if they can stop them.
Second and goal. Back to throw here. He's got his target. It's caught for a Colts touchdown. Tyreek Hill there to make the grab. And the Colts have got it on cruise control. I'm not sure what other ground there is to cover here. I mean, this offense has been amazing.
The midfield striping into Washington territory. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
They go right back to Mack. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Now they're staring at a third and eight. That last play backwards a yard.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were and down he goes. DeMario Davis coming in for the sack that time. They'll start on the ground with Mack. A broken tackle on the run, and then just on the other side of midfield, they get to it. It's a six-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
So the Colts in possession of the football as we get you reset. They've got a second down now as they look to salt this one away. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a third and four.
It's now third and four.
They'll look to throw here. And it's Josh Hill complete. And he is going to have a Colts first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. A 14-yard gain for Indianapolis and also move the sticks. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. On the ground, it's Mack. And this will be a gain of five as he gets it to the 30.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
But Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for Indianapolis, they continue to make their case as a Super Bowl favorite as they move to 13-1. And they will hit the road next week for a date with the Cleveland Browns.